Now let's look at how to use public transit directions in Google Maps. I'm going to zoom in on the Seattle region. But instead of the city itself, which has too many routes and options, let's start simple, using two suburbs in the urban area. For example, these ones, Kent and Auburn. These cities are close, and they are connected by both bus and train. I'm going to turn on directions and choose transit. This time, for the starting point and destination, I'm going to click on both cities directly on the map. Here is Kent and Auburn. And you can see that Google suggests only one option, the next bus departing, and it will take 23 minutes. This happens because, by default, the departure time is set as leave now. And although Google sometimes shows up to 3 or 4 suggestions, this time there is only one, because the next departures are all the same bus, every 15 minutes. And you can notice that if you switch this option to choose a specific time of departure, for example, 11 a.m. And that's useful because you can see the next travel options from that time. Then, to check the next results, you can click on this arrow to see later times. Let's click on the date and choose a Sunday, because it's usually the day with fewer options. And look, the buses are still frequent. Even this time, they are running every 30 minutes instead. Basically, exploring departure times on different days is useful to understand how well two cities are connected, even on weekends. Now, let's check out the details of one of the journeys, this one. And since we choose from Kent to Auburn, without mentioning any addresses, the app usually selects a central point within each city, and will probably suggest a route between main stations. So, let's zoom in on the map, where the Kent point appears, and you will see Google suggests starting from Kent Station Bay, right next to the railway station. Then, the bus follows the yellow path to the destination stop, which is the Auburn station. Next, when we look at the bus journey in the panel, it usually shows the number of stops and sometimes more info like the platform number, useful in larger stations, or in this case, there's a symbol meaning that this bus is wheelchair accessible. Then, I click on this arrow to expand and view all the stops in between. At the bottom, and I think this is very useful, we can often find the links for the bus company website. And for this case, the company also provides a direct link to view that specific route's schedule. And another one to check out the ticket prices. Between these two cities, it's also possible to travel by train, even though most of the journeys are in the early morning and late afternoon. For example, if I change the departure time here to 4 p.m, you will now see train options appear. The name of the service is the South Line, and the travel times are much faster, taking only 7 minutes. To understand this is a train, you have to look at the transport symbol here, which is slightly different from the bus symbol, this one. Then there are actually several different icons for each type of transport, like trams, usually represented with an overhead cable. Then there are also symbols for subways, cable cars, and even the monorail, which is a type of transportation that you can find in Seattle. Going back, let's now see the details of this train journey. First, we have the train number, which is 1513, heading to Tacoma Dome Station. Also, if the company shares any important notices or updates, they'll usually appear here as well. Finally, about tickets and information, you can access the train company's website. This time it's Sound Transit. But now, finding the schedule isn't as straightforward as before. as we need first to select the transport, which is Thunder Train, and then the South Line here. Click on Find Schedule, and here you can see the full timetable of that line and when the train stops in Kent and in Auburn. Finally, I want to share an important tip. I recommend always checking the timetables on the official websites, especially if during your search you see a message like, "We don't have the most recent timetables in this area." Also, at the time of recording this video, many transportation companies were not yet sharing their routes with Google, which means some services might not appear here at all.